Welcome you all to the short summary of Mother Courage and her children with the important facts. Background to Mother Courage and her children. The play Mother Courage and her children was written by German dramatist Bertolt Brecht with significant contribution from Margot Steffen. Margot Steffen is a German actress, writer and translator. She is one of his closest collaborators. This play is set during the 30 Years' War. What happened during 30 Years' War? It was a religious war fought in the Central Europe between 1618 to 1648. It resulted in the death of over 8 million people, including 20% of the German population. Initially, it was a war between the Protestant and Catholic states in the Roman Empire, but it gradually developed into a general European war. It is one of the most destructive conflicts in human history. Thus, the play is set during this 17th century turmoil of 30 Years' War. The play Mother Courage and Her Children was written during the early years of the Second World War in the year 1939 and against the backdrop of the rise of Hitler. Hitler's authoritarian intentions had become clear to many Germans and writers by the mid-1930s. Brecht himself opposed to the man Hitler, and he himself called him the Great Bandit. It means a robber or an outlaw. The play was written when Brecht was in Sweden. Although it was written in Sweden, the play is concerned with the Germany of past and the Germany of Brecht's present. The play is a warning against the capitalism and the consequences of war that Brecht is living through in Germany. Wartime involves a capitalist structure in this play. And it is to be noted that the lower classes, the peasants and the soldiers and the traders have no real way of gaining from the war. Let's see the characters in Mother Courage and her children one by one. The first one is Mother Courage. She is the title character. Her name is Anna Furling. How does she get the name Mother Courage? She earns her name Mother Courage in Riga when she runs through the bomb attack to sell her loaves of bread, as she is a canteen woman in the army. She has three children, Elif, Swiss Cheese and Catherine, whom she tries to take care of and protect throughout the play. It is ironic to be noted that she loses all three children following the war in Europe. The play ends Mother Courage alone with her wagon. Catherine. She is Mother Courage's daughter. Catherine is a teenage girl and is obsessed with babies and small children. She is killed in an attempt to warn a town about an imminent siege or the danger of military attack that is going to happen. Elif. He is Mother Courage's eldest and favorite son. He is much prized for slaughtering peasants and stealing their livestock. It is so ironic that he is executed during peacetime for doing the same action. Mother Courage never knows of his death. Swiss Cheese. He is Mother Courage's younger son. He is too honest and portrayed by Brecht to be rather stupid. He takes a job as a paymaster and is caught for hiding his cash box and shortly executed after that. The cook. He is the cook for the Swedish general. He becomes Mother Courage's sexual partner and he is referred as Peter the Perf in the play. Betty Portier. Betty Portier is another character in the play. She follows the cook and becomes prostitute in the army for 5 years because of this cook. Betty Portier picks up a colonel and convinces him to give her money with which to buy Mother Courage's wagon. Later in the play, she is married to this colonel's brother who is much older and rich. It is to be noted that she has sold herself completely to the war, but for a good price. She is the only person who gains from the war, that too because of her beauty. The next character is the chaplain. An army chaplain, he is a personification of Brecht's view that religion is of no use when it comes to war. He complains throughout the play that his clerical talents are going to waste, yet the virtues we might expect from a religious man seems permanently absent in him. Apart from these, there are soldiers, recruiting officers and sergeant. The recruiting officer and sergeant recruit men for the army and distract Mother Courage and Elif with the promise of a sale and beer. Sergeant, it is the rank given to senior officer in the army. The plot summary of Mother Courage and Her Children. The play is divided into 12 scenes with epic staging, songs and music. The play is set in spring in 1624 at Dalarna in Sweden during the 30 Years' War. When the play opens, Mother Courage, a canteen woman in the army, pulls her cart with her three children, Elif, Catherine and Swiss Cheese. In this wake of the army, she trades with the soldiers and attempts to make profit from the war. We are next introduced to recruiting officer and a sergeant who complain about the difficulty of recruiting soldiers for the war. They distract Mother Courage with the promise of transaction and take Elif away from her. Now one of her children is gone. The story then takes place after 2 years. We can see Mother Courage bargaining with the cook over a capon, and it's a chicken, a domestic cock, for eating. On the other side of the stage, Elif is praised by the general for heroically slaughtering some persons and stealing their cattle. Elif sings the song of the girl and the soldier, and Mother Courage joins him. The songs are very important in the play, as it's specially employed by Pratt to show the unreal world to the audience who are watching. It is also one of the features of epic theatre. And here in this scene, Mother Courage criticizes Elif for risking his life so stupidly in the war. Next, the play is set after 3 years. Swiss Cheese, Mother Courage's younger son, has taken a job as a paymaster. Thus, he has fallen like his brother to work in the war. Betty is introduced and she sings the song of fraternization to warn Catherine about the horrors of her relationship with the soldiers. The song describes the relationship between Betty and Peter the Puff. Peter the Puff is later revealed in the play to be the general cook, and he is also the sexual partner of Mother Courage. Next, Mother Courage, the cook and the chaplain discuss about the politics in the war. During their conversation, there is a gunfire, drumming and explosions to announce the arrival of Catholics and their attack over the army. The chaplain discards his robes suddenly to disguise his identity as a chaplain. It is because he may be caught if he is identified as a chaplain. Meanwhile, Swiss Cheese hides the military's pay box. Later in the same evening, Swiss Cheese is captured in an attempt to return the pay box to his general and is eventually shot. Mother Courage denies his body when it is brought to her to be identified. It is so pathetic to note that his body is thrown into a pit. In scene 4, we can see Mother Courage is waiting outside the captain's tent to complain about her damaged cart. We might have expected her to mourn for the son she has lost as a result of the Catholic attack. But she is more actively concerned with the loss of her trade. She also sings a song to a young soldier, a song of great capitulation. And this song details the way she, when she was young, with high ideals and aspirations. But now, like everyone, she has succumbed herself to willingly participate in the war. Bracht himself said that this song is bitter and condemns Mother Courage that she is so wicked in scene 4 than any other scenes in the play. Next, the play is again set after 2 years. Mother Courage talks with the chaplain about whether or not the war will continue, as she decides to invest more stock for her cart to sell. The chaplain suggests that Mother Courage could marry him, but instead she rejects him. Mother Courage then curses the war as it has disfigured her daughter Catherine when she promotes goods to be sold. She also again sings a song that praises the war as a good provider for doing business. The good news arrives that peace has been broken out in Sweden. Catherine, who had been waiting to get married during peacetime, is so depressed of her disfigured situation because she is again sent to work repressing her sexual desires. Her wounds were dressed by Mother Courage, and Catherine, for the only time in the play, curses the war. Betty, now a rich widow, much older and fatter, informs that the cook was once her lover. You see, the story is not in chronological order. It jumps here and there. It is fractured. It is the important technique employed by Bertolt Brecht. Elif is dragged by soldiers because he has slaughtered persons and stolen their cattle.
It is so ironic, since it is a peace time, no one is allowed to steal anything from anyone. Elif is executed for it, but Mother Courage never knows about it. Mother Courage, who has gone to town, returns with the news that the peace time is over after all. The play then shifts to the 17th year of the war. The world is now in a bleak condition, with nothing to trade and nothing to eat. Mother Courage and Catherine hear an anonymous voice singing about the pleasure of having plenty. While Mother Courage is away for town, the Catholics again enter with their group to attack the Protestants. Catherine gets a drum from the court and climbs onto the roof to announce for the safety of people in the town. As she is dumb, she beats the drum to try to awake the townspeople so that the siege can be anticipated. The soldiers return and shoot her, but before she dies, she is so successful in awakening the town. The next morning, Mother Courage sings a lullaby over her daughter's corpse and pays the peasants to bury her. It is so pathetic to note that the court rolls back into action. But it is now easier to pull, since there is so little left in it to sell. I want to read the last lines of the play, Mother Courage and Her Three Children. The play ends with a song. With all its luck, with all its danger, the war moves on but will not quit. And even if it lasts forever, we shall get nothing out of it. Starvation, filth and cold enslave us. The army robs us of our pay. But God may yet come down and save us. His holy war won't end today. Christians, awake. Winter is gone. The snows depart. Dead men sleep on. Let all of you who still survive get out of bed and look alive. These lines are beautiful, ironic and pathetic. The lines encapture the whole theme of the play. It also reminds us about the futility of war and the damaged souls who walk endlessly at the business of war. Themes. There are many themes in the play. Let's see the important themes one by one. The first one is families and parenthood. The play examines war not only on a capitalistic system but also on a domestic level. The play is not about any leading political figures of the time, but it is all about a mother and her children. Mother Courage's treatment of her children emphasizes the difficulty of her role of mother with that of her professional role of canteen woman. The play's key question is whether her trading helps her family. It helps, because it is the only way for them to survive, but it also results in the death of all her children. It is so ironic to be noted, whenever one of her children dies, Bracht ensures that Mother Courage is distracted by business affairs, but not by her emotions. The next theme is low classes during wartime. Bracht's play sets its focus firmly on the lower classes affected by war. Mother Courage, her family and her companions are all little people, and it is their story Bracht finds interesting. They usually are unable to extract any benefit from the war. The minor characters in the play are given only a profession to describe rather than a proper name. So we have only persons, numerous soldiers, generals, clerks, captains, officers and even chaplains. The third one is war as a capitalism. Bracht was a lifelong socialist, and after the First World War, the idea began to become more popular that war was often associated with financial gain. The play portrays a capitalistic system of war designed to make profit for just a few players, and it is perpetuated for that purpose. Thank you.